Good afternoon, shoppers, and welcome to Studio Anvil. I'm Anvil. This is my co-host.
Izzy.
Try not to laugh because she didn't know that was coming. So today we're doing an interesting project in the vein of Radio Anvil. This is the meat I spend most of my days driving around. I have a mem stick that I try to keep very condensed, so it's really what I'm listening to now.
I don't know why he calls it mem stick, but yes, it's just his current music.
It's a mem stick.
People call it USB, but that's off-topic.
I call it a mem stick. I'm older.
Okay.
But anyhow, but a lot of this music is music that you introduced me to because we spent the first, like, 10 years of her life, maybe not even that, listening to basically what she wanted to listen to, or what I wanted to listen to. Now we basically only listen to what she wants to listen to.
I have good taste in music.
Yes, and then she plays it on guitar and sings. It's wonderful.
But today, what we're going to be doing is, well, what he's going to be doing, I'm just going to be here and
agreeing and disagreeing?
Yes, exactly.
Okay, I got you.
But the best song per letter, so the best song starts with the letter A, and so on throughout the entire alphabet. This will be a longer video just because of the nature of it, but in the comment section below, we'll have timestamps for each letter if you want to get through it quicker, I guess.
Yeah, and this is my condensed. Someday maybe we can visit, like, my bigger mem stick that has, you know, just a more variety, old and new. But this is what I feel like I have to hear every single day. And I'm looking at some of the titles and I'm like, wow, I'm either a really good parent or a really bad parent.
We'll see.
There's mindless self-indulgence on here. So let's start. This is the letter A. Okay, so here we are with letter A. This one's kind of a slam dunk. I mean, there is some Pauly Royale, All My Friends on there. But honestly, this is a slam dunk. Which one is it?
I'm guessing Automatonic Electronics Harmonic.
What?
The Steam Powered Giraffe song.
The Steam Powered Giraffe song?
I don't know. You loved that
what
song.
What is the first song on the list?
Oh, Attic with a Pen.
Attic with a Pen, 21 Pilots. I listen to that song on the daily. It speaks to me. And I don't know if that makes me happy or want to curl up in bed with a blankie.
Very good song. As you've heard the little clip at the beginning, it was no surprise to you. It's a very good song. I do recommend listening to the full thing.
On to letter B. Is a crazy suicidal head case, but you specialize in dying. You hear me screaming, father, and I'm lying here just crying, so watch me with you. All right, we're on to letter B. This is the one that kind of spurred it, because thinking off the top of my head, because I'd been listening to H and I today, but I was thinking about B's for some reason, and this one was a tough one. Because you got, there's actually four songs on there that I don't ever skip. And that's Blood Like Lemonade, The Boom, and Bones by Mel Parsons. I love The Boom by Pauly Royale. I love More Chiba's Blood Like Lemonade. Makes me think of Umbrella Academy. Awesome song. But in all honesty, coming from a little Australian murder mystery that I watch, Bones by Mel Parsons would be the one.
The top B.
Yeah. Yeah, because I know More Chiba and Pauly Royale will be there somewhere. But that is her best song. That was a good song.
That is a very good song. Again,
I'm guessing yours might be Blood of Lemonade.
Mine, actually, off of this list is Back Mask. I don't know why. I just really love that song by MSI.
Oh, my God. You try to be different at every
no,
turn.
No, I really like that song.
I should have guessed
that. It's kind of clever. Long story short, you know, there's back masking in music and it's supposed to be satanic. They made their back mask area, like, very positive and uplifting, and the song beat. More or less.
Yeah, there you have
evil,
it.
Evil, I guess. I don't know how to describe it properly, but it's just interesting.
Yeah, there's some good songs on B. That's a tough category.
There was. There's quite a few on there that you'll see.
Yeah. And on to C. All right. Well, I thought B was hard, but C is a nightmare. I mean, it's almost like it's a clear cut. I already know who wins. But I'm dealing with, just to go over a few of these really quickly here. California by Youngblood. Love that song. Car Radio. Casual Affair. Castle by Tom McDonald. I mean, come on. Cemeteries by Pauly Royale, right? And then the one that I mean, Come to the River by Rhett Walker Band. It's a Christian song, but it is such an uplifting song. It is really the most uplifting song I've ever heard. So after listening to my favorite, Car Radio, by 21 Pilots. I like to listen to Come to the River and Feel Better Again.
So which is your response, though? What's
the best one? It's Car Radio. I mean, look at that. Chlorine's on that list.
Yeah. You got a lot of choices. And a lot of
Crimson by Morcheeba. Cut My Lip. Well, Cut My Lip. That's never in the running. Let's be... Casual Affair probably wasn't really in the running either. And what is yours, weirdo?
A lot of these are songs that I also really like. Yeah, but I'm going to have to go with Clarissa. Cemetery's number two. Number two is better than number one.
Oh.
They're both very strong.
You know what? Air bump right there. Oh, that was a real bump. Oh, that's why we're family. We're allowed to touch. Oh, man. I also order at Wayfair. And on to D.
I have these thoughts, so often I ought to replace that slot with what I once bought. Cause somebody stole my car radio, and now I just sit in silence.
I thought this one would be a really interesting one. I've got to ponder it for a second. You know what? I'm really happy that you put in Cemeteries by Paul A. Royale, because they deserve, you know, a I spot. Mean, I would put Dying in a Hot Tub as my favorite right there, but to be on, I mean, and I love Dear God by Tom McDonald, but it's sometimes not the easiest song to listen to.
There's so many good ones on here.
But for me, the one that I'm never skipping presently, this is, we're talking okay. 2020,
yeah.
You know, the fun year. It's gotta be, cause everybody's on drugs.
I was like, are you gonna let me?
Nah, that's called holding for suspense.
Yeah, this one, I was actually between,
Disco Pogo? That's one of their worst songs, by the way.
I was actually thinking, Drugs, Falling in Reverse, very good song, but I'll have to go with Palais Royale again with Die for Something Beautiful.
Oh, that not song, Dying in a Hot Tub.
That song
dying
is so
in
pretty.
In a hot tub.
That song's just really pretty. Nice love song. Whatnot. All of that. Good stuff, I guess.
I know, you notice I got this really weird reggae mix going on, too, because it's Deo by Johnny Osborne. Deo! Deo! On to E. All right, so we're talking about the letter E here on my mem stick. This one's tough in the fact that there's not much to choose from. E is not a strong category. Well, we've got a snoring dog in the background.
No, she's sneezing.
Oh, she's sneezing. I'm sorry. I think because a lot of times I just need to, like, calm down from beating my steering wheel, pretending that I'm Josh Dunn. I really am so for 21 Pilots, aren't I? I think it's got to be Another Handsome Gentleman, Panic at the Disco, End of All Things.
Fair enough.
You found it like, fair enough there. You just outed yourself on national television. Brandon Urie.
My answer for E, that's actually very difficult. I'm going to have to agree with you. The End of All Things.
Oh, I love how you said, I'm going to have to.
Well, it was between that and Evening Wear. Evening Wear is a very... It's a situational song. Sometimes you don't feel like listening to it.
And you might not want to, like, play that right now.
Exactly.
I got it. Oh, yeah.
You got to write that down, yes.
I'm in charge of writing down the the selections for later. And on to F. We are young again. Okay, now we're on to the letter F. This is the first time in my life I've ever censored anything, but I had to censor a few of these things because my daughter has raunchy taste. Again, my father of the year or the worst father ever? I don't know. We'll see. We'll see how she turns out. If she's ever the president of the United States, you'll know I failed. Ooh, political. So this is F. This one was a little bit weird for me. It really, there's two, but because I really love Fairly Local. I love that. You can see I have got the little mixes and stuff up there. But in reality, I think Palais Royal has earned their spot on my list. And Messing With My Head I love that song. So I would say out of that one, I'm not going to skip Effing With My Head.
And I'm going to have to go with Friend Please.
Ooh, I didn't even see that.
I love that song. It's, again, one of those ones that makes you cry for the right reasons, I guess you could say.
Yeah, maybe that one kind of hits home. Yeah. I don't even see it. Oh, it's right there. I got lost because, you know what? My eye went right to fruit. Because I just love how she spelled fruit like that. Hello, I am Marina. Right in the diamond. Fruit. Here is Marina to say, on to G. You torture me, but the G's won't scream. All right, this is G, and I've got decisions to make here. I mean, I love that song, Give Me Hope, Johanna. That's about apartheid, something that my generation fought against, much like people are fighting for whatever it is nowadays that they believe in. Goner, that's a great song. The Great Chinggis Khan, love it. Guns for Hands. You know what? Words of the Immortal Trench. Knuckle Up. Guard Your Grill. Naughty by Nature takes the top spot. I can't skip that. That's a classic hip-hop rap song. And if you notice, there's not a lot of classic hip-hop on here. There's one song on here. Knuckle Up, Guard Your Grill. I've never been to Tokyo. He says that in there. Huh. Who says that in music? That's why that music appealed to people like me. Huh. Yeah. Oh, lies like Pinocchio, never been to Tokyo. Come on now. That's a strong candidate for number one. And that's why it wins over one of my favorite songs, Guns for Hands. I would never skip Guns for Hands. And you see, I've got a lot of versions there.
This one, you're not going to be expecting this. Do you have a guess?
What's the weirdest song on there? Oh, you got Girls, Girls, Boys. That's a good song, too.
Well, which one do you think I'm going to go with?
I am guessing, if I had a guess, I would say Guitar Smash by Mindless Self-Indulgence.
No.
No.
My actual answer is based on what song is going to get me the most hyped off of this.
Right.
The Who. Great. I have to. It gets you so hyped. Their music is all amazing. It's like Mongolian
throat singing. The Who, H-U. Mongolian throat singing.
Yeah. If you haven't listened to it, look it up, please. I guarantee you will be so hyped for everything after listening to any of their music.
Hanyu rock is the genre. Huh. Yeah, they are really worth it. They are classical. They use traditional singing methods, traditional instruments, and they can make a bass guitar sound like a freaking horse coming over the horizon. It's pump you up music. I mean, this is workout music to the extreme. You know what else is extreme? The letter H. Alright, this is H. We keep saying these things are hard, but come on. I mean, hang on to yourself.
The mouse, you can take it.
Oh, yeah. I mean, happy, the hard way. When I'm feeling down, The Hard Way, no, not The Hard Way, Hang On, right there, by Tom McDonald. That's the one I go to when I'm really feeling down. I mean, Heavy Dirty Soul, Hip Hop is Dead, by Nas. I don't think I'd ever skip that. Hold On, Alabama Shakes, I love your version better. Holding On, Hometown, Honeybee, my honeybee. Hospital Beds, oh my God. Ugh. Ugh. How will I rest in peace? She's gonna cut my head off.
He's been singing that song.
But I don't care.
Kenny Hoopla.
Kenny Hoopla. Yeah, you see it right there. Well, you can't see my mouse that I'm moving. But, I mean, honestly, you know what? I got to be honest with you. We're talking right now, aren't we? We're being very specific. We're saying which song out of all of these, if you had to skip all the rest of the songs, which song? Hello, Shooting Star. That's from the end of Assassination Classroom, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Oh, my God.
It's an anime outro.
I know. I'm demented. I've really lost my mind here. I mean, honestly, no. But you know what? You know what song I'm not... You know what? I'm going to be honest. Okay. I'm talking about right now, right here. We're keeping it current.
Okay.
I listened to it 5 times in a row today.
Oh, okay.
She's going to cut my head off, but I don't care.
How Will I Rest in Peace?
Yep. By Kenny Hoopla. I got to be honest.
The rest of it.
I mean, the hype is probably the best. Yeah, give it another, 6 months of me listening to the same song over and over again, and it'll be back to the hype. But right now, right here, it's Kenny Hoopla. I don't even know who he is, man.
My favorite...
Was he part of Mott Hoopla? That was a band, I think. Mott and the Hooples? I don't know.
My favorite all-time on this list.
All-time.
All-time. Not currently. It would have to be Honeybee.
Bye, Honeybee.
Because that one's kind of sweet. It's emotional because, you know... He started singing it with me, and I found that very sweet. I'm going to be honest.
Yeah,
but
there you go.
But skip-wise, for currently, it had to be Hospital Beds. I really like Palais Royale, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, I felt the same way about Hate Me. Like, that, I'm not skipping. I'm playing it over and over again.
Yeah.
But, I mean, if you're ever down, it's Hang On by Tom McDonald. That's a really good song. It's a very good song.
Happy Marina and the Diamonds, I'd have to say, is also kind of like
yeah.
That's a very good one.
Yeah, depends on your mood. So I guess our mood is moving on to the letter I. She's gonna cut my head off, but I don't care, I don't care. All right, we're on to I. This should be a little quicker. I mean, I'm not going to generally skip I Am the Spring by Morcheeba, but, oh, man. See, life, man. Because I was just like, well, this is easy. This is I'm a Mess by Frank Iero. But is it really? Because if I could only choose one to not skip. Oh, if you were here tonight, I never skipped that song by Steen Thorpe, who I don't even know who that is. But, I mean, honestly, the one that I would geek the most about easily is In the Dark. Bring Me the Horizon. I love that song. I mean, I'm sorry, Frank. I feel bad. Frank's a nice guy. I'm sorry. I feel like shit. No, I feel bad for Steen, too. You know? Oh, no! Wait a minute. Last minute change here. I'm sorry. Did I say In the Dark, a song that even has like a hint of positivity? Oh, no. I meant to say, I'm such a dumb dick, aren't I? Mindless self-indulgence. It gets worse.
That was my answer, too.
Yeah.
It gets worse.
I guess I didn't even see it at the bottom. It gets worse. I mean, I'm sorry, but I mean, as you've seen by my... My talking here today, it only gets worse. All right, let's see. Let's hope that J is easier. Because it doesn't get better unless you're better. It doesn't get better. All right, shoppers, we have a 2-for-1 deal here. We are going to bang out 2 letters at the same time. Do we dare? Yes, we do, because it's very easy. Jumpsuit 21 Pilots, not even close.
I didn't think about mine.
Tick tock, tick tock, ding dong.
Yeah, jumpsuit.
Yeah. And then going into K, I mean, I love Kill You All in a Hip Hop Rage.
But you're going to go with Kids from Yesterday.
Of course. Yeah. You believe it or not, I never liked My Chem. I never liked 21 Pilots. But you know what? Sometimes if you have an open mind, good things come in.
What do you think? Kitchen Sink.
Yeah, you would like Kitchen Sink. Why
is Kitchen Boy? Oh, it makes Lane Boyd in Kitchen Sink.
Yeah.
I was very confused for a minute there. I'm like, huh?
Yeah, Kitchen Boy.
I like
Boy.
Kitchen Sink. It's a good one, and I have it on vinyl. Just gonna.
The actual regional at best? That's not printed anymore?
Yeah, I actually have that one on my wall.
Wow, how'd you get that?
We went to a record store.
Yes. We went to a record store.
Yes.
I worked in record stores. Or I worked in one, and then I worked in a lot of video stores.
Huh.
I've led an interesting yet Deadly Dole Life. No, not even close. On to L.
Jumpsuit, jumpsuit, cover me.
We're on to L. I'm trying really hard not to pick 21 Pilots again because I feel like I'm just fanboying at this point. But, you know, trying to be honest. Lane Boy, I'm never going to skip that song. Little Bastard, same way.
That's all of them.
Oh, that's all of them right there. And Lovely, I'm not going to. Lonely. But, I mean, you know what? I'm just going to be honest. I really don't care. Like, why do I care? Let Me Love You by Janita is a really good romantic, smooth jazz song. I love that song. Swear, little bastard. Is Lonely the one that has All of My Friends? All of my friends, all of my friends.
Lonely?
Yeah.
No.
I'm thinking of something else. Oh, I'm thinking of All of My Friends.
Yeah.
Yeah. Whoa.
Nice virus and threat protection.
Yeah, no, that's just letting me know I'm an idiot. I out of that list, I guess I gotta go with Lame Boy. I mean, look how many versions I have of it. Even if I wanted to skip it, I can't. But I love Lovely. I really do.
It's a very good song.
And I love Little Bastards.
On Love, I'm doing Love the Void by Palais Royal.
Really?
I really like Palais Royal. I guess we're supposed to see them live, but everything happened, and now we can't see them live until they postpone it. And get it set day.
Unpostpone it.
A little bit angry, but that's okay.
Yeah.
Still good music.
Yeah, and we still have to move on to M.
Know how I would have found this, regardless. All these songs I'm hearing are so heartless. Don't trust a perfect person and don't trust a song that's flawless. Honest.
Alright, we're on to M. And this one's tough. I mean, I guess I say that every single time. Maybe I know what kind of music I like. I don't know. I love the medley mashup by 21 Pilots because they do Attic with a Pen live on there. You know that?
Yeah.
You know that?
Yes, oh. I did know that.
But I love Mantra and I love Mary. I mean, you know, those are two great songs. Mother Tongue by Bring Me the Horizon. I mean, My Blood. But, you know, all of these are kind of equal. And I really think that if I was listening to all of these in one day, I'd need to kind of move around. Moving to B stage, some of that stuff was really great. Bootleg Lives. My by Troy Sivan.
I thought you were going to say that, yeah. But I didn't say it out loud.
It's kind of poppy, and I think it's a perfect, like, change of pace. If you were making this as a playlist, which we will, if we can, I don't know if all these songs are available.
They
but,
should be.
But, you know, to mix it up a little bit, throw a little bit of, like, upbeatness into there, I'd have to go with him. Plus, I couldn't use him in the last one. Lucky Strike. I love that song. Heard it at a Hot Topic.
I
sound so awful. I do, don't I? Like, I like Hot 21 Pilots, and we go to a Hot Topic.
My answer is Mary.
Oh, I knew that. That was a given. Yeah. I mean,
that song makes me cry every time I hear
that's
it.
Why I don't, that's why I don't listen to that song.
Yeah, I get
the
that.
The Umbrella Academy arc is just, like, seared into my brain. It's, you know what it's like? It's like Obstacles by Syd Barrett. Or not Syd Barrett.
Syd Matters.
Syd Matters, thank you. I was thinking of the Pink Floyd singer.
On Life is Strange.
On Life is Strange. Oh my God, I'm gonna tear up.
Don't.
I'm just.
Tear up. Instead, go to M.
What?
I don't know.
Oh my God, I think
you've
it's...
been doing intros. I wanted to try.
Go to Ed.
No, I said N. Oh. I said N.
Oh.
I guess we're leaving this in if you're hearing it. Would you like to do your own intro now?
On to N. Alright, we've composed ourselves and we are on to N. Oh, this one has a lot of sentimental, because I'm pretty sure right now if she's reading the list, she's like, oh, he's got that song. But that's not the song that takes it. I love Neon Gravestones. I love Na Na Na. I mean, this is so, but quite honestly, out of those, because now at this point, I have to pick, like,
I know
out of those.
I know which song.
What is it?
I have an idea, which is one that you might not mention, and you're going to regret not mentioning, New York, St. Vincent.
That is actually the answer. Ah. I never skipped that song. I love that song. I saw that on PBS. She was doing a concert, like Austin City Limits, something like that, and I just saw that song, and I'm like, oh my God, that was just a beautiful song. Very beautiful song. And it has to be because Never Wanted to Dance, Neon Gravestones, Nicotine, Nihilist Blues.
My answer. You overlooked it.
You really think I overlooked one?
I think you overlooked one.
All right.
Nobody likes the opening band.
I knew you were going to love that. I forgot I had put that on there. And then I saw it. And I'm like, oh my God, that proves I love her. I'm a pathetic dad. On to O.
New York is in New York without you, love.
All right. So Izzy just had to sit through me singing New York by St. Vincent. So go out and listen to that if you haven't. On to the O's. And oh my gosh. This might be a little bit hard, but I don't think so. I just got to remember to read all of these.
Yes.
And I don't know if I could really include mediocre at best songs, because those are remixes.
I'm not going to ever include any of like the blends or the remixes.
Yeah,
I'm just going straight off.
Some of those are good. But out of this one, this one's really hard for me, because I would skip pretty much all of these. I like Oceans by Frank Iero. And I'm guessing, Old Song Medley. But that's a bootleg. That's a bootleg. That's not even a... So, yeah, Oceans, Frank Iero.
Only hope for me is you.
Yeah, I knew you were going with that.
Yeah, MCR.
I knew you were going with that. You should have let me guess on that one.
You should have guessed.
Yeah, I would have gotten that
you
one.
You would have gotten that
one. I'll still pat myself on the back for Oceans. On to P. Alright, so we're on to P here. We're starting with that song, Pale. That's a good smooth jazz. I probably wouldn't skip that because I'd probably need it. I like Parents. I mean, that's another one of those songs that just, like, you know, grabbed me from the get-go. Pet Cheetah. Pop Goes the World, by the way, is a good song. This is a smooth jazz remix of Pop Goes the World.
There's also a Yo Gabba Gabba cover on here.
Is it really?
Yeah.
Is it Blank All Night?
Party in My Tummy.
Oh, Party in My Tummy, yes.
MSI covered
that. I really don't like Pantaloon all that much. Polarize is okay. Man.
Well, what's your answer?
I think it's going to be, if I'm remembering the song correctly, and I'm pretty sure I am, I think it's going to be Primary Propaganda by Paul A. Royale.
I'm going to go with Pretty Things by Big Thief.
Oh,
yeah, see, I'm pretty
sure.
Guitar, so.
I'm pretty sure Big Thief's gonna come up on my list somewhere else. I sort of know where it's got a huge advantage going forward, according to the polls. You know what else the polls say?
What else do the polls say?
On to R, like a pirate.
Bye. As the clock declares our time, and it goes on and on and on and on.
And we're back with R's here.
R's.
I think this one might be one of our simpler ones, really. Ride was one of the songs I hated by 21 Pilots, so remove that. Run and Go is all right, but really, for me, different people have done covers of the same song, and there's other versions that's better than this one. Sorry, Delroy Wilson, but still, you get the top spot with By the Rivers of Babylon. Yeah, little reggae. Got to throw a little reggae in there, right? And it truly does win it, because that is my favorite song on there.
You know which one I'm going to go with?
Ragdoll.
No.
No.
Revenge.
Really?
Revenge Live is better, though. His dance moves, Demirian's dance moves in that song.
So do we include dance moves in this?
In this one, yeah.
Okay. Well, then, on to whatever letter's next. That would be S. S.
When we remember time.
All right, this is S. This is painful.
Lots of songs.
Because this was, for me, my initial thought was this one was simple. This was exactly where Big Thief takes it, right?
Mm-hmm.
With Shark Smile, right? That's a great song. I mean, that Shug Shug's there, Shut Me Up, Scarecrow, Savages. I mean, I just put Marina and the Diamonds back on, straight to video. That, I mean, I can't, like, I'm listening to Shut Me Up on repeat all the time. Yeah.
Straight to video, very good song. In all honesty.
Yeah, straight to videos up there. I mean, this is not this. I thought this was gonna be Shark Smile by a landslide, but then when I look at it, I think, man, that's Screen by 21 Pilots. Shug Shug by The Who. I mean, talk about, if I need to be pumped up, I'm definitely picking Shug Shug. If I'm just like at the end of the day, I'm picking Shark Smile, you know. But I mean, I listen to Shut Me Up on Nauseam. So, I mean, currently it has to be Shut Me Up. Because I would skip Shark Smile to get to Shut Me Up.
Yeah, I'm agreeing with you. Shut Me Up, yes, it is their big song, but it's their big song for a reason.
Yeah.
It's simple, the lyrics are just simple, but you can still, like, enjoy it.
Yeah, I thought for sure you would be picking Shark Smile by
Victoria. I was also between Scarecrow.
Oh, I love Scarecrow. But MSI has already been on the list, and again, I'm you know,
yeah.
I'm zigging his Shug Shug, though. That's hard to not be on there. Shug Shug. Yeah, that was my best right there, my best Mongolian accent. But so Shut Me Up, and on there, I believe it is the original version or
original video. Yeah,
I think that's the one that starts with all of the like.
Yes, it does.
Yeah. That's a good impersonation of Electrical Circuit.
Isn't on Spotify. The one on Spotify is terrible. The original crappy demo. It's literally called that. It is very bad.
Yeah.
If you want the original video version, it's on the Our Pain, Your Gain. So you're going to have to look for it.
Oh, and Smithereens. He did that live, didn't he?
Yeah.
Yeah, and the piano, like, sort of right out in front of us.
Yeah, it's a cute one.
And I was also doing
Summertime. There's a lot
of jazzes. I knew you were going to say that.
That's a cute song.
I mean, you know, and then there's a song called Song by Mindless Self-Indulgence.
Great at naming, aren't they?
It's probably our worst recommendation, just so you know. Like, if you take any of our recommendations.
Don't take MSI.
Yeah, I would say MSI is probably the one we're going to fail on, because
they're good if you like that style.
Is it an acquired taste?
I guess so.
It's an attitude, but I mean, they are. I mean, the bassist is Gerard Way's wife.
Yeah.
Boy, I actually got that information out. Let me see if I can do the next bit. On to T. The bass, the rock, the mic, the trouble. I love my coffee bright, just like my metal. Quick updates. First of all, the playlist, if it gets made, is going to have Shark Smile because we think that's a better song to share. And apparently, I need to remove all the Boy Pablo from my mem stick.
It's not bad music. It's just memories, I guess, is the way to put it.
Yeah, exactly. I understand. Ooh, trees.
Ooh, trees. Sound crazy.
That'll be the... That'll be the way home. Oh, man. I think Trees is probably the... No, you know what it is? The World Is So Effed Up by Michael Franti. I mean, how am I not going to be playing that right now? I mean, that's 2020 in a nutshell. And
this song, well, you can't see what I'm doing, but.
But would I, skip it for Trees? Oh, man, you know what didn't make the list?
Mm.
Isn't it Forest?
Yeah.
Oh, down in the forest. Oh, my goodness. Oh, but Tongue Tied. You know what? Tongue Tied Together. I've been singing that all week, so if we're being current, it's got to be Tongue Tied.
You might be able to get mine. I'm going to do the intro on table.
Okay. I'm never going to get it on table.
This is gospel. It starts with the heartbeat.
Oh, wait a minute. That's on the list?
Yeah. The piano version. The one that you can find on YouTube. He's just playing on the piano and things are falling on the piano. It sounds weird in concept, but it's actually very beautiful.
Oh, man. If I ever had to call a tie, I didn't even see that. This is gospel.
I was also between the Tower of God opening. I really do like that song. It's very catchy.
Yeah, you're right. I mean, you're absolutely right. If we were doing the best of those, it would definitely be This Is Gospel. But right now, I'm more... I don't know.
Tongue
I feel
tied mood.
Yeah, more energetic kind of going thing, you know. Oh man, I don't know about that. Hold on. On to you.
Every morning I ride on a carousel to the sides of my mind that I kind of help.
All right, we're on to you.
And V.
And now we're on to V. And the winner of V is Vegas Lights by Panic at the Disco. I'll be honest with you, with the U's. None of those songs ring a bell with me. Not even one of them.
I like Uncle.
Yeah, but it doesn't ring a bell with me.
It's an anti-bullying statement, in a sense.
Yeah, but I'd skip all of those songs. I'm just going to keep it real.
Fair enough.
If I have to pick, which one did you, the Uncle? I don't know. I just don't know. I don't even know what I'd put on a playlist out of those.
And Vampire Money is my V.
Yeah.
It's just kind of funny how, you know, Mike Him, if you don't know the whole story behind it, Twilight was inspired by them. So for when the Twilight movies came out, they wanted MCR, and they said no. But then MCR went on Yo Gabba Gabba, which I find hilarious that they would, you know, not want to be on this multi-million dollar franchise, but they'll take Yo Gabba Gabba and make a song for an original song, not even...
Yeah, but Yo Gabba Gabba's oozing with originality.
Yeah.
I mean, you know.
I guess that's why.
Twilight? I mean, they ruined your name, man. I thought your name was going to be unique. We chose Isabella to be an old school unique name. And it turns out to be the most popular one of the year. Because I like to make lists, but I don't really do so while reading them. And I never looked up the popular baby names, and that's how she ended up with Isabella. True story.
That's why I go as Izzy and not Bella. If someone calls me Bella, I'm like, no, please don't call me Bella.
Oh, gross. Punch him in the throat. Oh, gross. All right.
You know what's not gross? The letter W.
W is not gross, so we should move on to that. All right, so we're on to the not gross W here. I see a few that I probably wouldn't skip. I mean, Weeds. And depending on my mood, What a Heavenly Way to Die. I believe it's the name of the song. It's cut off on my screen here by Troye Sivan. Oh, I just like that guy. I love White, but the problem with the song White by Pauly Rael is you did a cover of it, and I really like the way you did it. And for some reason, of all the music you've made me listen to, that's one of the only songs that sticks out. And but Weeds? Oh, wow. Where's the Boom? I like that one, too. But I think after talking about them all video long, Who wins it right there with Wolf Totem? I mean, that was the one, that was her first one that we heard, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Uwe, which is on
Double. No, I heard what? No, I heard Wolf Totem first, I believe.
Huh.
Yeah, because Uwe I discovered later.
No.
Yeah.
I played that one first. That's the one that came up on my list.
Okay,
whichever one was first. It was one of the first, for sure.
Yeah, but I'm pretty sure it was Wolf Totem.
I'm going to go with Warhol, Palais Royale.
Ah.
Yeah, it's
okay.
A good song.
All right.
And because there's only three songs for Why, we're just going to do Why right now.
Oh, we are? Yes. There's only three?
Yeah.
Oh, Uwe. Oh, this one is, this one's actually a slam dunk for me. Yeah. Desmond Dekker. Circa the early 60s. You can get it if you really want it.
I think that's a classic. I think most people know that one.
Desmond Dekker.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go.
So you were saying I don't even need to sing it?
Uwe.
Really?
Yes. Huh. The Who gets two of my spots. Wow.
Oh, yeah.
They're good, yeah. Alrighty. Final words.
Oh, there's no Z's?
No Z's.
Oh, you know which one? Oh, that's the name of the group, Zipper Club. You remember them?
No.
Nah, but anyhow, they had some good songs.
But you don't have it on here, so it won't count.
So what would be a song that you would add to this?
Oh, wow. I wasn't expecting that. You go first. Do you have one in mind?
Yes. I do. Falling in Reverse.
Coming Home?
No. The new one.
Coming Home?
No. Carry On.
Oh, I was thinking of the album. Well, it's on Coming Home. Well, it was supposed to be. So
yeah.
I give myself a half point.
That's an easy choice for me.
Do I have one? I'm trying to just go off the top of my head.
Do you want
me
to make it easier for you?
Eh.
What would you definitely not put on here while we're out driving? That you just... the one song. Sid Matter's Obstacle... Or A Little Dog Cried.
A Little Dog Cried. That song is so sad.
That is the greatest song, one of the greatest songs ever written. Jimmy Rogers,
A Little Dog Cried.
A Little Dog Cried.
It's very hard to find, surprisingly.
It's on Spotify.
It is.
Yeah, and it is a very sad song. And that's all I'm going to say about it, but it's a song that dates way back into my childhood. My mom was a fan of his and actually had his album, and I grew up listening to very old folk rock, Kingston Trio, stuff like that. But that song, heartbreak. Did you think about what you would add to this song?
Oh, to add that I would add to the list?
Yeah.
Oh, shoot.
No, see, look at that.
No, I didn't.
It's probably got, you know what it's got to be?
What?
When I was.
Welcome to the Black Parade. I don't know if I want that while I would be driving, though, because I feel like I would veer off the road as soon as I heard that.
Really? You'd veer off the road?
I would veer off the road.
So that's another song that you wouldn't like. I knew it would make one of those two lists. So you're never going to find it in
time. Just going on my thing, and it would have to be off of here, off of I Brought You My Bullets, You Brought Me Your Love. I'm going to have to go with Early Sunsets Over Monroeville. I love that song. It's, I don't know why. Good song. Old MCR, very good. Better than the new stuff, for the most part.
Ooh, you're being controversial.
I am.
I'll fight you.
Danger Days is an exception, but once you go to the newer MCR,
it
goes down for a little, then it goes back up. It's all good.
Because I didn't used to like them at all.
I listened to all their music.
I already had my depressing music. If I wanted to, if I needed like mental clarity in depression, what would I listen to?
I don't know.
Oh my God! How can you not know? It's blatantly obvious. There's only one choice.
No.
I'll give you a hint. It's not their album, Final Cut.
Oh.
My God, she forgets about Pink Floyd, The Wall. Attention shoppers, is there anybody who wants to be my co-host? Because I'm going to have to get rid of this girl. Well,
you know a lot of sad music. I had many options, didn't I?
No, there's only one option, Pink Floyd, The Wall.
Okay, fair
Comfortably
enough.
Come on, that's why it's not on there. Veer off the road. That's on my main mem stick, and someday maybe we'll review my main mem stick, and I'll learn how to speak better. Until then, thanks for shopping with us, and likes, subscribes, bye-byes.